this old house is still standing year after year.
Cracks filled with laughter, windowsills stained with tears.
As the walls collect memories to pass down the line,
history tells a story. Another face, another time.
I'm Glenn, and this is Bobbie, and we're making trees talk. My parents bought me my first mandolin when I was 5. My parents took me to a festival in Colorado called Rocky Grass. It was like a whole new world. Everybody could play. So it was something that I really wanted at that point, and now it is my life. You can only be as good as the mandolin you play. And I learned that really quick. I was going to college in Branson at the College of the Ozarks. Mandolin was my main instrument, and I was focusing really hard. And my teacher said, you just have to get a new mandolin. It's holding you up, you know, you're not learning fast enough because your instrument is not good quality. And I went home and told my parents, and they went out and bought some wood and a book. And my dad said, here, we're gonna make one. And we made the first one together. If you want something so badly, you can make it happen. The main difference between our mandolins and other people's mandolins are right here. There's thousands of people out there making mandolins that look exactly like Gibsons. And if you want a Gibson, go buy a Gibson. If you want an original handmade instrument, that's our main thing. We do different body shapes that nobody else does, with different sound holes that I design myself. Well, it starts out with a tree. That tree might not have even known that it wanted to be a mandolin. But by the time it's getting close, it's starting to scream, I want to be a mandolin.
A lot of our cedar came from a forest fire that was in Alaska in 1934.
On some of these instruments that we have, you can actually see the smokiness in it. You can see the burn marks on the outsides. For some reason, it's just spectacular wood. Starting from the blocks of wood, you have to make sure, especially with the soundboards, that you're straight quarter cut. That's kind of a difficult process because a lot of these old pieces of wood that we use, you can't even see the grain on the end, you know. If it's cut right and then arched right, if it's got everything right, then it starts reacting the way that you want it to. Every piece of wood that we touch, we tap tune. That's just telling me how thin I need to carve it or how thick I need to leave it. But once it's carved properly for the piece of wood that it is, then it starts to really come to life. And you can feel every vibration once you get to the right point. The mandolins themselves tell me when they're done. Whenever they respond properly the way that I want them to, then I'm satisfied. Well, my favorite part about making mandolins is watching Bobbie bend sides. She's really good at it. I mean, and it's not an easy thing to do.
I pick out very specific pieces every time that I bend sides. This flame is gonna be really nice. This one needs to go this way. I make sure that they book match. You know, the emotional attachment really is just doing it.
Just being beside her every day is enough. The mandolins, they are derived from our relationship. These mandolins are like our children. We spend so much time with them. We put literally our heart and souls, blood, sweat, and tears, everything into these instruments. Music is a powerful thing. It's just overwhelming. If it's a song that you've heard when you were a child, you're gonna go back to that exact moment when you heard that song, that exact memory. Music makes the world a better place. We're just blessed to be a part of it. When a mandolin comes to life, I feel elated. When you do something right and you can be proud of it, it's very powerful.
Thank you.